What's up everybody? Welcome to TCM Outdoors. Today we're going to do an installation video on a left-hand throttle. This is made by fullthrottleinc.com. That's their website. I'll put it right down here. And first step, make sure you read the instructions. So what the left-hand throttle does is it essentially puts a throttle over here so that when you are pulling on your mud strap in the mud hole, see if I can get me in the picture, when you're pulling on this mud strap like this, you have somewhere that you can pull a throttle. So it's going to go down here and it has a safety on it, which is a really nice feature, so that you can just remove that when you need to use it, otherwise you can't pull the left-hand throttle. So it's great. So in the step-by-step procedure, the first thing that we need to do is we need to loosen all these items up, which I have quite a few items here because I have a winch controller, the switches, main switches for the bike, the headlights, engine, and then the reverse override. This is a 2019 Polaris Sportsman high lifter. I really feel like this is going to be very handy for this bike. So basically we're just going to loosen up all this stuff and we're going to shift it right on over to make this much room, because this throttle needs to mount in between the hand grip and the switches. And I have aftermarket hand grips on this, so if you do not have aftermarket hand grips, it will actually fit even better. Alright, let's get to doing it. On the Sportsman high lifter, there is a little plastic plug here. You can just use a flathead screwdriver. I'm using a tool to take the rivets out on the bike. And then we have a 3/32, and this is just a set screw that makes this guy loose. Next step is to take a T30. I just so happen to have it in socket form, and loosen up the brake lever bracket. We want this loose enough that it'll easily slide, so I'm going to give it an extra little turn here. All right. And since I have a winch controller, I'm going to go ahead and loosen that up as well. Okay, now that all this stuff is loose, you just simply push it over. Okay, so just before this is tight, I'm gonna go ahead and pull my switches back over and tighten them up, and then retighten my brake lever. No need to over torque that set screw. Make sure that you put your little piece back in. You don't want mud packing in there. See, I can still adjust this, but I can put everything else back now. During this process, because it better suits my needs, I'm going to go ahead and move the winch controller to the other side of the brake lever. Okay, now that we have successfully got everything positioned where we want it, we make sure that our brake lever is straight up and down, kind of level across the top. It doesn't look like it in the camera, but it is in fact level. I'm still going to leave this just a little bit loose, just for ease of putting the cable in and everything, because I have to thread the cable through. So in my kit, this came pre-assembled, but I do not think that this is the proper piece for my unit. It also came with this piece, which seems to fit a lot nicer. So I'm gonna move the pieces from here to here. Okay, now that I've done that, it's important to mention this screw is actually the set screw for the cable, as the cable will go through this hole eventually. My kit came with two large Allen type or hex screws. For this application, it will use the larger of the two. There's already a hole in the bottom of the throttle lever that this guy is going to thread into. There we go. Took a moment to get it started, but it's threading right into the plastic. Now, you'll notice with my index finger, I'm holding this piece tight, and my thumb, I'm holding the lever from getting away from me. This way, it's installed firmly. Be careful you don't break your lever. Okay, so now we're going to take our cable. We're going to unroll it. And you will notice that there's only one end that's silver. That is the end that is going to go towards the new throttle. Okay, so we're going to take this end and we're going to weave it through. I'm going to go underneath. It says you can go under the padding. So we're going to consider that this gauge pod is the padding because of its location. And we're going to push it right through here and get it through to the other side. I'm actually going to go to the other side now that it's through and figure out where I want it to come out at. So now I've decided that I want it to go under my throttle cable because I don't want anything on my original throttle cable to hinder its movement. Next step, we're going to insert the silver end of the cable into the Goldfinger. Now it's time to remove the safety. Do not lose that. Now that you've set your safety in a safe place, it's time to get out the cable itself. If you squeeze the Goldfinger, you can actually feed the cable through the wire. And then I call this a little hammer end. You'll see there's a line in the Goldfinger. That's for the cable. And then, so this just sits right in here, like so. It'll snap all the way down. You continue to feed it through until the wire is straight. Now is a great time to use a cable tie on this side, making sure that the cable is pushed all the way into the Goldfinger. Next, we will comfortably route the wire so that it looks good and is functional, checking periodically to make sure we don't have too much pressure on it. There's nothing on the end of this wire and it is not binding at all. In this next step, we're going to use the provided cable ties and wrap up the wire, keeping it in the contour of the handlebar. Be sure not to tie up the factory cable and also not to strap it too high to where it can't function properly with the throttle assembly over here. Now, it's time to take the other silver insert provided and slide it carefully. It's very soft, so you don't want to bend it. I'm going to slide it all the way down on the cable. This protects the end. And next, we're going to take this little accordion looking thing, not sure what it's called, and we're going to slide it down and put it on top of the cable. And then we push the cable through here finally. And this is where the adjustments come in. We're going to have a little bit of adjustment in the cable to have it in the right position. And we're going to have a little bit of adjustment here. We do not want any pressure on the throttle when you adjust this. It needs to have a little bit of loose point. And only finger tighten that for now. And make sure that our throttle cable is going to work good, our regular throttle. I am finding that I cannot achieve full throttle, which I want to achieve full throttle. So I'm going to add another cable tie. If you do not want full throttle, you can skip this part. Okay, now I can achieve roughly 3/4 to 7/8 throttle. I think that's going to be good enough for me. You'll notice I added one more wire tie so that I could achieve that. Now it's time to tighten this cable down a little bit better. I'll use a pair of pliers to hold it on top, just to make sure we're good and tight. I can actually hear the throttle completely return, but we will fire up the bike to make sure that it's idling perfectly. This unit is supposed to idle between 1200 and 1250 RPMs. I'll squeeze the brake and turn it on. Now it is time to make sure that the Goldfinger is tightened all the way down, making sure it is at a 6 o'clock position. Nice and tight. Okay, now we're going to make sure that the unit is nice and tight, that everything is functioning properly. We're going to start the bike while the bike is in park and make sure that everything is functioning properly. Now that we have tuned everything properly and we have everything adjusted where we want it, we will trim this excess wire. There is a little tiny piece that comes. Be careful not to lose this. And it's about 1/2 inch long. You want a good sharp pair of either, well, some form of wire cutter that's going to easily cut this without smashing it flat. I chose actual wire cutters because I know they're good and sharp. And we're going to trim this roughly in a half of an inch from the end. Cut right through. And then we slide this guy on here. It's easiest if you kind of twist it just a little bit to the right. And then we're going to crimp it. There we go. Now it's on and it's good and secure. Don't forget to put your safety back in. You're going to want this while you're riding so that you're only using this throttle when you need it. Otherwise, you can make a mistake pretty easy. All right, guys, well, this is gonna conclude the Goldfinger installation video. You'll notice my safety is on and I'm going to go test this thing out. I hope I was able to help a bunch of people, and I really hope that this video is what was needed. I couldn't find any installation videos. It's very simple. Don't be afraid of it. You can do this. It's not bad at all. So, all right, guys, have a great day.